So, JavaScript constructor. So, in the last sessions, we have gone through JavaScript arrays and JavaScript objects. So, like to declare an array in JavaScript, we have first option to declare an array is new space array. So, this means a new instance of array object. And to declare an object, we have new space object. So, this means a new instance of JavaScript object. So what does this new keyword mean? So new keyword means a new instance of array. So to declare an array, we use new array, or we also have a shortcut that instead of using new array, we can use bracket, and for objects we use curly braces. So basically this means a shortcut of new array, and this means a shortcut of new object. So what's the meaning of this new and why we need a new keyword? See, let's start with a function. So to declare a function, we have two options in JavaScript. First, a function like function ABC, and the data type of function statement required a function name. Okay, sorry. So type of ABC is a function. But what if we use capital F? Now this is again something defined in JavaScript, but see, this is an error, so unexpected token this. So what is this function with capital F? So this means a new instance of function object. So it's a new instance. So see, this is a new instance of function, but type of fun is a function. Okay, so again we are using new keyword. So why we need new keyword in JavaScript? For that we have to start with JavaScript constructor. So JavaScript constructor, basically they are instance of classes or functions. So in ES6 we have classes, but before ES5 and ES4 we have only functions in JavaScript. So the inheritance model which JavaScript follow is called a prototype inheritance model. But in C++ and Java, we are actually following classical inheritance model. So in JavaScript, the inheritance model is called prototype inheritance model. So what is this prototype inheritance model? We have to start with this. To declare a constructor in JavaScript, the new keyword is used. So this means like new means a new constructor object. So array is a constructor object of array object, and this is a constructor object of JavaScript object. So this is, we have already done. In the last articles, we have gone through arrays and object. So they are actually instance of arrays and object. Now let's start with a user defined object and then create an instance of that object. So let's create a simple example. Let's say you want to your object name is a car. So for, let's say this is one of my car. Okay, now this car can have some properties like name, okay, model. And let's say fuel. Now this is an object, so it's an instance of object, but we can't say that there are some prototype properties of this object. So basically it's whenever we define a new keyword, so this is an object, it's a new instance of object, so basically it's different from other objects. Okay, so they don't have some common properties. So this is not oops. Now let's start with object oriented part. Create a function with car and C. I'm using C capital uppercase, but normally in function we use like this. We use camel casing. Okay, so this syntax means it's a simple function, and this means it's an object type. So we are defining a user defined object. So a function car with capital C, it's exactly like classes, a class. So this is a function named car and with three arguments, X, Y, and Z. Okay. And now to create instance of this car, like different car models, it starts with a variable or a simple car name. Let's say car name A. Now A is the instance of this car, so we have to use new then car and then pass three arguments. So A is the instance of car and B is also the instance of same car. Okay. So what is car? It's a function. What is A? An object, and B also an object of this car. Okay. So like object. So this is a JavaScript object and these are our custom made objects. So but these custom objects are instance of a car function. So let's comment this and see this syntax error. So car is not defined, so we cannot use car directly. So basically it's a custom defined object. So for that, first we have to create a function, and now with a use new keyword to create instance of those objects. Okay, so this function we have to create instance. So now we can also have three instance of this object, new car. So now we have three instance of car, A, B, C. So A is not equal to B. Why? Because A is a new instance of car, but B is again not equal to C, and A is not equal to C. All are different because they all are new instance of, like we have seen in the last class, an empty array is never equal to the second empty because this is a new instance of array and this is another new instance of array object. So so let's start with these things in details. So how to add properties. Okay, so let's start adding some properties. So first thing is that we have to declare an object type. So object type is defined by declaring a function. So we can use declaration or expression function. Avoid using arrow functions here. So we can't use arrow function in object type. So we define a normal JS function with parameters. Now this keyword is used here, and this means current object to assign properties like function car with arguments name, model, and let's say fuel. Okay, so now we have a function with three parameters, name, model, and fuel. Now add some properties. So it's simple normal JavaScript function, nothing different. Type of car is a function, and car can have length property, name properties. Okay, so these are two main properties. Now let's add. So now this always refer to the current object. So now this means the current object. So this dot name is equal to name. So the second name is actually my argument, and the first is a property. Second, this dot, you can also use some different keywords like variant you can use for model, and the third one here is fuel. So now we have three properties of parameters. So we have defined three properties of parameters. So this keyword is used here to define properties. So this means for the current object, name should be first argument, model should be second argument, and the fuel should be third argument. Now create the first instance. Okay, so this is a custom object type. So this is a custom object, like arrays and object are built-in, but these are custom. So see, the type of car here is in function. And now to create a constructor object, so let's start creating the first constructor object, which is a new instance. So let's say my first car model is this. So now Swift is not a simple JavaScript object. So if we use this, so this means this is an instance of JavaScript object. So but it, this is the instance of car object. So we'll say new car with three arguments. So let's say new car with three arguments. So first argument is name, second is model, and third is fuel. So now with the new car, First is car name. So let's say I say Swift. This is the name. Second is the model. I say that's it, ZXI. And the third one is the fuel. So which fuel I'm using? Let's say I'm using petrol. Okay. So type of car is the function, but type of Swift is an object. So see, Swift is an instance of object, okay, and it's not an array. So array dot is array is false, okay, and type of Swift is object. Sorry. Okay, so this is a custom object, but this is a, so this is an instance of object, this is an instance of array, and this is an instance of car. So the data type of this is object, and the data type of this is a function. But this is the first instance. So now let's type Swift. So now we can see there are some properties. So just open this, you can see name, model, fuel, and some underscore proto properties, which we will discuss later on. So this is my first instance. So Swift is an instance having three key values: name, model, and fuel. So depends how many arguments we are using, but all arguments. Now let's say another instance. This with different variant, and again petrol. So we have two different instances. First is Swift and the second one is Baleno. So this is the instance of car, this is the instance of car, this is the name, this is the name, these are models, and these are fuels. So now we are creating different instance. So these are constructor object, and to create a new constructor object, we have to use new keywords. So new means a new instance. So to create instance, we use new keyword. So let's see, this is the first car, this is the second, these are the, let's say we can add some more classes. So all new classes using new car are actually instance of capital car, this function. So this is called prototype inheritance. Okay, so this is prototype. It's quite different from the classical inheritance model where classes are used, but see in JavaScript we are using prototype inheritance. We can also add some three different object to use this. It's quite simple. Let's say p document dot query selector p in our HTML. Car name is, let's say we want to use the first one, so Swift dot name. So the car name is Swift. Model or variant is Swift dot model. And variant is, it's better to use template later, but as just because of some browser issues, cross browser issues, we still use the old syntax. Variant is Swift dot fuel. So this is my first paragraph. So car name is Swift, model is this, and the variant is this one. For the second instance, we have to type here Baleno. So we can see the car name is Baleno. So this is a different object, this is a different object, but both are instance of this car object. Okay, so we can create any number of more instance using the new keyword. So whenever we use new, so this means a new instance of this function. Okay, so like see, when we print this console.log, we can see car with C capital. So this means the parent function, name of the function, and these are properties. So dot name, dot model and dot fuel are property. So this is how we can check the property. This is name, model, and fuel. So what are the properties of constructor object? So all the car names are actually the instance of car function. The data type of car name is an object. So new keyword can create an instance of both function and class in ES6. So see, the same function, instead of function, we can use class in JavaScript ES6. But the model, the prototype inheritance model will remain same. Properties of each individual object can vary on arguments. So depends on the argument. And the last thing, to add property to parent function, like if you want to add some property, not to Swift or Baleno, to this car, we have to use prototype. Now let's start with what is prototype. So like in engineering, we say this is a prototype. So like we know that the prototype is ready now. So means the main product is still under construction. So they have just created a prototype. So prototype means means we are inheriting the properties from the parent. Okay. So it's exactly like, not 100%, but it's exactly like, it's just a prototype of an object. So in JavaScript, the actual model is, means how JavaScript is actually working is known as prototype inheritance model. So JavaScript is still a prototype based language. So as we already know that JavaScript is a prototype based language. So JavaScript is prototype based language because JavaScript support prototype inheritance model. This is one of the important thing in JavaScript, but this is very different, quite different from Java and C++. So that's why some Java and C++ developers think that JavaScript is quite different because they actually use the same model using class. So, but JavaScript also support OOPs, but without class and with class. So classes are added in ES6. So JavaScript introduced classes in 2015 with ES6 version. But before that, we are still using object-oriented programming by using function. So that's why JavaScript is quite different from other programming language. But still, after adding class in JS programming, JavaScript is still prototype-based language. So means even after adding classes in JavaScript, JavaScript is still a prototype-based language. So let's create a prototype property. Now let's add a property. Car dot prototype dot let's say parent. So the parent of this is Suzuki Motors and the origin country is Japan. So these are not properties of Swift and Baleno, these are actually properties of prototype. So means the car. Now check it out. When we type Swift, we can see the name, model, and fuel. So these are its own properties, but Swift can have two more properties now. See, country is Japan and parent is Suzuki. So now we can see two more properties, Swift with country, Swift.parent. So Swift dot, but there we can see only three properties. Why three? Because these are its own properties and parent and countries are property of proto, means the prototype. So let's create a for loop. For in where I in Swift and print the value in console. So we can see where I in. So we can see we got the keys, name, model, fuel, parent, and country. So it's showing five properties. But when we type Swift, so this is showing only three properties. So these three are the actual properties of car, but these are the total properties. So, but that includes two prototype properties, that is parent and country. So using for in loop, we can actually print all the values. So I stands for the key, Swift I index stands for the value. So this is key, this is value, key, value, key, value, key, value, and key value. Now, by adding a property to prototype, these properties are inherited by both the cars, Swift and Baleno. So see, if this is Baleno, now name Baleno, model Alpha Fuel. So see, again, parent is Suzuki and the country name is Japan. Okay, so mine means by adding a property to parent, we are, these objects will inherit those properties. So this is prototype based inheritance model in JavaScript. But if we want to print only these three properties, not the parent property, so for that we can check. That's how. So in the last session we have done this instance of. So Swift is so Swift, sorry, the property name. Name is the instance of Swift. 1 second. Name, model, and fuel. Right hand side of instance of is not called. One second, I think some issue with the syntax. Okay. Has one property, sorry. So we have to use has own property. So has own property will check whether it's his property or the property of prototype. Sorry for that. So has own property will check like Swift dot. So you won't get the syntax hint intelligence. Let's start here. Swift dot has own property name. So this is true. So this means name is a property of Swift. Model true and fuel is also true. Now type country. So we can see the false. So why false? This means this is not a property. So this is not a property of Swift. This is a property of prototype. So Swift dot parent is Suzuki, but so actually the parent is a prototype property of Swift and name is not. So see, name is undefined. So Swift underscore dot underscore underscore proto parent is Suzuki underscore proto dot name is undefined. So this means parent is a prototype property, but name is its own property. So to use name, use Swift dot name, but you can also use Swift dot country, but country can also be using proto dot country. So this means this is a prototype property. So to check it's a prototype property or not, we use like the, if we only want to print own property, we can use if use has own property. So we have to use has own property like this. So if Swift or Baleno dot has own property which I, then only print this. So print only has own property. So these are three has own properties: name, model, and fuel. But if it's not there, then we can see all the properties: name, model, fuel, and parent and country. So if we use if, so this means these are own properties. And if we use else, so else here is prototype. So let's comment this. So we'll get only these three properties. So if you want own properties, use if. To get only prototype properties, use else. To, if you want both, simply use this. So this means all properties. This only own properties and this only prototype based properties. So see, Baleno dot has own property name is true, but Baleno dot has own property parent is false. So this means parent is not a property, his own property. It's a property of car. So proto property is also used to check prototype, but in latest version of JavaScript, this has been removed. So object.proto.name is undefined, but object.proto.country is Japan here. Avoid using underscore proto. Why? It is depreciated now in the latest version of JavaScript. So the same inheritance model is being used by classes in JavaScript, and see how the classical inheritance model is working. So the same thing we can use using classes. How? A class keyword, let's say bike. And so let's create a class name bike. Okay, so bike is a function. Check the type of bike. This is a function, but actually it's a class. So inside we have to create a constructor. Okay, and this dot name is equal to name. This dot engine is equal to engine and now let's create the first instance. So let's say where, so new bike, first name, let's set this. So bike is a class and Hayabusa is the instance. So see, if we type Hayabusa, we can see the name is this and engine is set in it. So actually functions are working same like classes in JavaScript. So this is the ES6 way to handle prototype inheritance model with the use of class. But class could have some even more features in the future. Like we can also use public and private, but these things are still under construction. It means they are, there is a time after 1 year, 2 year when they will be, these all features will be done, and they are still under beta version, not the full-fledged version. And most of the browsers are not supporting public and private till now. So it's better not to use even classes in front-end JavaScript. We don't use classes because class is not supported by Internet Explorer browser, and very few browsers support classes. So instead of using class, we still prefer functions in JavaScript to use prototype inheritance model. But the functionality of both is totally same. There is no difference. See, type of bike is a function and type of Hayabusa is an object. Okay? So this is how the prototype based inheritance model is in JavaScript is working, and it's very different from the classical inheritance model of C++ and Java programming language. Okay, so that's about JavaScript prototype or prototype inheritance module.